The Democratic Party has a very obvious leader problem, you think? But the aging establishment is refusing to let go. My God, they just have to hang on. Look, here's the quick news. Biden, 79. Pelosi, 82. Majority whip, our majority whip, is 81. Durban is 81. He's, you know, it's like fossil fuel up there right now. It's Jurassic Park goes to Washington. Give me your take on it.
Well, look, this is something I'm really glad the media is starting to talk about these issues, because you and I have been mentioning this for years now. And it is starting to gain traction. You have more and more people coming out, talking about the ages of these individuals. Some of it has to do clearly with Biden, with his age. That is a huge story out right now. But also, I think I got to give most of this credit to Diane Feinstein, you know, who is going to be 90.
Yeah.
And the fact that
still, I mean, if you put a mirror under her nose, will it create condensation? Every time I look at this woman,
right,
I think.
But when those stories came out a couple months ago saying she doesn't recognize people on the Hill, like her staffers, she doesn't know them.
Yeah.
Her colleagues, she doesn't recognize them. That kind of kickstarted the conversation a little bit with most normal, non-political news consumers saying, wait a minute, if we have members of Congress that pharmacists have said, yeah, I filled Alzheimer's prescriptions for them, I can't tell you who, but I have. We have people that have just basically aged out. You know, we as a society tend to look at people, whether it's accurate or not, but once you hit your 80s, we say, okay, well, this person, you probably shouldn't be driving a car. You need help getting around. And yet that's what we have in leadership, making our laws. We wouldn't trust these people to drive a car.
Watch all of them, from Biden to Pelosi, halting speech, constant gaffes, almost a need to take breaks because they're overwhelmed with the pressures. But nevertheless, the Democrats, for some reason, ended up with it worse than the Republicans. And that's interesting to me. Give me your take on that.
They really did. I mean, the Republicans have been trending younger. They appoint younger justices to the Supreme Court, to the federal courts. They understand that we have to pass the torch to this new generation. These folks on the Democratic side are unwilling to do that.
Yeah, I think of John F. Kennedy when he came into office. He said, the torch has been passed. He was one of the youngest presidents at that point. Torch has been passed. We have a new way that we look. Out of there came Camelot. And the whole notion of Camelot was a new, fresh Democratic Party. Politics are fresh again. These folks are hanging on for their damn life. I guess it's a good moneymaker for Pelosi, because she's the insider for insider trading for the old man who's making a bundle of money. So I don't know. I guess it's just an economic decision. But why did the Democrats allow it to happen? That's the problem.
Well, you know what's important to point out, too, is when Kennedy gave that speech, these people were either teenagers or in their early 20s.
Really? Yeah.
I mean, so they say, okay, the torch has been passed to us. I guess somebody has to come along and remind them, you have to pass the torch as well.
Yeah.
You don't get to hold it for the next 70 years.
Yeah.
You've got to find new people.
Clean the house.
Yep.
Clean the house. If they don't, you've got younger voters that these folks could be the great grandparents. Understand, the great grandparents of younger voters.
Right. And these are the people that think that, oh, we can put on the little kente cloths and kneel down. And
yeah,
that's
cool.
Enough for these people.
Yeah.
That's all they want. Nancy Pelosi calling the Green New Deal the green thing.
Some of it is. I mean, that's the amazing thing. Some Democrats look at it like, oh, yeah, this is okay. They have a lot of experience. Thank you for joining me, Farron, okay?
Thank you.
That's all for this week, but all of these segments are going to be available this coming week right here on this channel, and you can follow us at Twitter at America's Lawyer. I'm Mike Papantonio, and this has been America's Lawyer, where we tell you the stories that corporate media won't tell you because their advertisers won't let them or their political connections won't allow for it. The truth is, we call balls and strikes. Stay tuned. We're here every week.